TFNN. Headline news update. Here's Tom O'Brien.
Good morning, everybody. I'm Tommy O'Brien, coming to you live from TFNN headquarters in St. Petersburg, Florida, 10 a.m. Eastern time on Monday, 30 minutes into the trading week. And we got some tariff fears. We got markets starting off to the downside, but getting a little bit of a pop off of those lows. Dow Jones, negative 318 points, or about 1.2%, trading at 26,186. S&P's off 32 points, or about 1.1%, trading at 29.12. NASDAQ tech could be hit the hardest by some of those tariffs. NASDAQ down 111 points, or 1.36%, trading at 8,052. Start things off. Let's take a look at the VIX this morning. As you would expect, quite a spike on that VIX, reaching 18.80 early, as the markets were down as much as 500 in the Dow. You got a bit of a pop in the markets. VIX 16.90 currently. Jumping over to the futures markets, we'll start it off with the major indices. We'll start it off with the Dow. And so let's back it up first. There is your fall off between Friday and when futures opened last night. You had the Dow closing at about 26,500. You opened near 26,000. Flirted around 26,000 for most of the overnight session, and then the market opened at around 9:30. We're a solid 150 points above that level. S&P's much the same. We opened dramatically lower. We hang around that level for most of the overnight session early in the morning, and then the S&P's trade from about 28.95 now up at 29.11. NASDAQ 100, quite a fall off as well. We were up there at the end of Friday, 78.71. You made it down to a low, basically, of 76.75. So you're talking about almost 200 NASDAQ 100 points, currently trading at 77.40 off the lows. Crude oil trading higher at $61.70 currently. You got gold trading at 1279.71. Gold, a little bit of a sell-off. You saw a pop on that market fall off, but nonetheless, gold can't hold it, 1279, and euro US dollar, some volatility there as well, euro trading 111.90. In terms of what else you have happening across the market, one story out there, pretty dramatic. Let me pull it up. Where are we? Talk about that one. The Kentucky Derby, quite a Kentucky Derby up there. If you didn't catch it Saturday, they had a disqualification, took about 20 minutes. Seemed to be the right call after they showed those replays. And where am I? I'm looking for Boeing. There we go. Boeing did not disclose. 737 MAX alert issued to FAA for 13 months. They knew about having problems with an indicator light. It was supposed to be standard. It ended up being optional. Boeing this morning down 2.4%. Stay tuned, folks. Come back at 10 o'clock with Tom. Live programming all day. Have a great Monday.